Before you judge me, I know this doesn't have a lid, okay? I'm fully aware. I need to do my dishes and I kind of can't find the lid. So that's how that's gonna go today. My March favorites. I didn't do a February favorites, and that's because, not that I didn't have favorites in February, it's just that I don't try out new products like to the same extent that a lot of beauty gurus do. Like I don't have the money to, and I know it seems like I buy a lot of makeup and I do, but I don't have the money to buy like that caliber, like that amount of makeup, to where I'm like trying new products like every single week. I just don't. That's the reality. Well, I'm probably only gonna be doing favorites like every other month, just for the sole fact of like you'd probably be seeing repeats if I didn't. I know my hair is a mess. It's wavy and it's just not. It's bleh. Like I didn't do it this morning because I was way too tired. Anyways, we're gonna start with the favorites. I'm gonna start with like non-makeup stuff, which is only like two things. So first off, I have this candle from Bath & Body Works, and this is the Jasmine Waters. It's just like a green candle, and it obviously has jasmine in it, which is one of my favorite scents. White jasmine petals, cool water, soft violet leaves, and beech bark. So I like really clean, like fresh scents. I'll probably repurchase this one if they have it, but I like to try like different scents from Bath & Body Works because I really love their candles, especially their 3-wick candles. So I'll probably repurchase this one and like a new one. But yeah, at the Tayla was talking about they had like a marble collection, which I'm down for, so I might check those out. But yeah, this one's really good. It smells nice and fresh and clean, and it's just dandy. Next, okay, I hated this next product for its intended use, but I found another use for it. This is the L'Oreal, ooh, it's wet still because it was in my shower. This is the L'Oreal Evercream Sulfate Free Shampoo. It's like for hydration, but it smells like, I don't even know how to explain how it smells. It's apricot oil. So it just smells like clean, to be honest with you. Like, I really don't know how else to explain it. If you know what apricot oil smells like, that's, I guess that's what this scent is. Not that it didn't like do, it's not that it did like any damage to my hair. Like my hair actually felt really nice after using it. I just don't, or I mean like my hair felt soft. My hair just didn't feel clean to me after I used this. My scalp doesn't feel like I washed it. So like that sounds really weird, but that is a common problem with sulfate-free shampoos. I'm actually gonna switch to a purple shampoo anyway because I'm trying to get my hair to lighten, because I wanna go back to blonde, which is my natural hair color. I don't know if you can tell, but it's got a lot of brassiness in it from when I had like, because I had really dark brown hair with like red undertones, essentially. And my hair naturally has red undertones in the first place, but I want like a dark ashy blonde when I go back to blonde, so I want to use like a purple shampoo to kind of get rid of that brassiness. Anyways, I just wasn't a huge fan of this, but then I needed to wash my brushes like halfway through the month at some point, and well, I mean obviously I wash my brushes like every week, but I ran out of my Sonia Kashuk brush cleaner, which like wasn't like earth-shattering to me. It cleaned my brushes, you know what I mean? Like it was cheap and it cleaned my brushes, so that's what I used. And so I was like, fuck, well I guess I just gotta use like my shampoo. And so I grabbed this thing got like all the pigment out of my brushes. Like they looked like I just freaking bought them. Like, you know how they have like the foundation stains? That was gone. Like this stuff is awesome for cleaning your brushes, and it does it very quickly. So if you're looking for a good brush cleaner, this is like $6 and it's gonna last you a hell of a long time, especially if you don't use it for shampoo. So I highly recommend this for a brush cleaner. For shampoo, I don't know, it's kind of up to you, it's your opinion, because some people really like sulfate free washes, but like my scalp just doesn't feel clean. I have one more not makeup thing. So this is my perfume that I've been using like crazy this month. but it's called Pink Ice. It's from Rue 21. I don't know if that's like everywhere. I know it's a thing in Arizona. I don't know where else they are in the country. I'm sure there's more than Arizona though. It smells really good. Like, I have to like smell it to describe the smell. I know it sounds weird because I use it every day, but it's like a fresh scent mixed with a flowery scent. I like really clean, fresh scents, but this adds a little bit of sweetness that isn't like overwhelming. It's like a clean sweetness. It's not like heavy, like think of like Sweet Pea, not like, what's the vanilla one? Like Sweet Pea, not warm vanilla. And it looks pretty, so that's a plus. Okay, I just got this yesterday, but I just gotta talk about it because I love it so much. So this is the Too Faced Chocolate Bar Palette. It smells so good, first of all. Second of all, these colors are freaking gorgeous. Like, let me just swatch a couple for you. And I mean, I know you've probably seen this thing everywhere. I mean, it's not new, obviously, but I am literally in love with this palette. Oh, I don't know. That was like in a really awkward place to swatch. But yeah, those are the swatches. It's highly pigmented. All the shadows are like extremely creamy and buttery. I can't say enough. And you know what's funny? A funny story is, I'll insert the picture right here, but those of you who follow me on my Instagram, you know. I actually bought the Too Faced Chocolate Bonbons palette because a lot of the reviews were saying that that was their favorite one out of the three. And I really liked the brighter colors in it. And so I grabbed the box. It's, as you can see, it says Bonbons on it. And the receipt also rang me up as Bonbons. And I open up the box and this bad boy comes out, which I wasn't mad about because I was planning on buying both the original and the Bonbons anyway. And that's fine. I'll get the Bonbons palette when I get the Bonbons palette. It's not a big deal. I love this. Like, it was a very happy accident. I'm okay with it. I'm more than okay with it. There's not a single color in here I won't use. I mean, the purple one's a little eh, but like, I want to experiment with these two bright colors. It's beautiful. It's a perfect neutral palette. It's great for starting out. It's great for if you've been into makeup forever. I cannot believe I waited this long to get this freaking thing. Like, honestly, I wore it to work last night and to school today. It's not what I'm wearing right now, but wore it to school today and I got so many compliments at work and at school. I love this thing. It looks amazing. The mirror is not the best in the world, especially for a $50 palette. I'll admit that. But I love this. Like, this is gonna go with me on vacation. I love this so much. I've only had it for a day. Super long lasting, lasts through my shifts, my days at school. It outlasts my foundations. But yeah, I can't wait to get my hands on the Bonbons palette, especially after trying this, because it's great. I mean, I don't know why. I mean, like, everybody and their mom talked about it, and I knew it'd be good, but I didn't think it was this good. Like, I need to listen to y'all better. I used a couple eyeshadow palettes quite a bit this month, and one of them is probably going to surprise you, because it's pretty old. So, actually, they're both fairly, like, they're not very new, but I used this palette all month, and this is the original Naked palette. And I have a lot of reasons why I like this. Everybody knows the pigment's amazing. The quality of the shadows is amazing. They're long lasting. They blend easily. They're beautiful. I mean, I don't know what else to say about it. Everybody knows. Everybody's all about the Naked palettes. Well, a lot of beauty gurus are telling me that are, you know, say, have been saying in their videos recently that they're, you know, overhyped. I disagree. I think these are well worth your money. If I had to choose, and I love this chocolate bar palette, don't get me wrong. However, if I were to get somebody their first makeup palette, this is the one I would choose. It has all the neutrals in it, and it also has a great little section over here for some smoky eyes. So, I mean, you can't go wrong with this. It's super neutral. It's always gonna work for you. It won't fail you. I promise you. It'll never fail you. This is your rock, man. It's your rock. Yeah, they're beautiful. I'll swatch a few. I'm sure you've seen swatch upon swatch upon swatch, you know, but that one's really creamy. I never noticed that, so that was half baked. So yeah, they're gorgeous, and I, like I said, you can't go wrong with them. Is that all of them? 1, 2, 3, 4. There should be one more. So yeah, they're beautiful, beautiful colors. They're perfect. They're neutral, and I mean, they're good for, especially if you work somewhere where you can't really have dramatic look. I've been using it like pretty much the entire month. For some reason, I just got on a Naked kick. I don't know what it was, but yeah, great palette, been using it a lot this month. Rediscovered that bitch. Second palette I've been using a lot this month is the Kylie Cosmetics bronze palette. Yes, I know, her brand has been in kind of some hot water lately. Personally, I don't really buy her cosmetics aside from her eyeshadows. I don't see the point in buying her liquid lips because I've heard from a lot of people that the Ultra Mattes are very similar from ColourPop. Those are like $6. I'll buy those. You know what I mean? So like, I typically don't stray because I love her eyeshadows. I haven't bought the peach palette because I just can't get myself to do it, the Royal Peach, but these are awesome. This is great for perfect everyday looks. That's why I've been using it so often, with all the tooth pain. Oh shit, did I just get, no I didn't, okay, sorry. With all the tooth pain I've been having and the being sick for a month, it literally this month was a roller coaster, guys. I started off March with croup that evolved into bronchitis, got better. Then I was told my tooth needed to be pulled because it started throbbing and hurting really bad the day I got better. Got my teeth pulled, and now I am in the process of fighting off a UTI. So yeah, personal information, I know. But it's been a month. It has been a motherfucking month, let me tell you. Anyways, these are really creamy, great quality. I'll go ahead and swatch them for you. I'll swatch one from like each row. I'm just trying to pick. So yeah, they're very creamy, very pigmented, as you're seeing right now. So yeah, those are the swatches. That's not very organized or that great of a swatch. That's my fault, not the shadows. But they're very creamy, great quality shadows. A lot of people talk down this brand, but honestly, her eyeshadows are on point. I'm wearing the Holiday palette right now, and I love them. I use them all the time. They're perfect for everyday looks and when you want something quick. It's great. This is great for when I go to school. This is all I wear, mostly when I go to school, unless I'm feeling fancy and I wear my Naked or my chocolate bar, which I wore today. But 99.9% of the time, this is what I'm putting on before class. Because they, and don't get me wrong, the chocolate bar and the Naked blend out beautifully. But these, I can blend out to a really easy, casual, smoky eye like that. Like, I can be done in 5 minutes, and that's why I picked this for, you know, work and school. So yeah, if you're someone who's wanting something quick and fast, this shit's good. I know it's expensive, I know, but it's worth it. Like $40 for a palette with no mirror, that shit's expensive, I get it, but it's worth it. They're great shadows, and yeah, I use them all the time. So, foundation, okay. So, drugstore option that I've been using, which is usually what I use when I'm, why is it wet in here? Oh, the shampoo. So anyway, drugstore foundation that I've been using a lot this month has been this combination. It's the Pro Glow and the Pro Matte. I'm pretty sure this was my last favorites video too. I love these. I do. I'm sorry. I can't stray. So, I dropped the mail. Is anybody else waiting for their refund? Because I am. And I would like to have that shit. Moving on from the foundations. Or from the drugstore foundations. You guys are gonna be shocked by this after that word. But I've been using Kat Von D a lot this month because I love the coverage. However, it is not the best for my dry skin. So my solution to that was my baby right here, the Too Faced Hangover RX Primer. I mixed this with this. God bless America. I love this foundation so much because it's thick and full coverage and it will not budge. But the problem is my skin is dry AF. So you mix this bad boy in and it's perfect for my skin. So yeah, I've been loving these two together as a high-end foundation and this as my primer in general. I use this under every single foundation I use, including the drugstore foundations, unless I'm feeling really porous. And then I use this guy, which is my other favorite primer this month. So yeah, this is my favorite high-end this month. Super high coverage, won't fail me, lasts all day. So yeah, that was that. And then these are my two favorite primers this month. This helps to thin this out a little bit so it's a little bit better for my skin. And this helps to minimize my pores a lot. Like you can tell, like it's almost gone. I need to go buy a new one. So yeah, I loved these this month. Lip stuff. I still have eye stuff. Oops. I go out of order. What can you do? Liquid lipstick this month. I've been loving the ColourPop liquid lipstick Ultra Satin in November. It's a really dark mauve-y nude. It's a really dark mauve-y nude, and I just really like it. It looks great on your lips. It's super comfortable. I mean, everybody knows the Ultra Satin lips are really good quality. They feel great. I mean, everybody knows about them. I mean, they're great. If you're thinking about diving into this brand, do it. It's a great brand. It's super affordable. I haven't had an issue with any of their products. I love all of their products, except for maybe I got a color I didn't like. But the formula, on point. I love it. Second lip product is this Urban Decay, I think it's High Color Gloss. Yeah, High Color Lip Gloss in Drunk Punch. This isn't the one that I've been using the most all month. When I've been using the most is in my purse, and I don't want to go grab it. But it's the same formula, and it's in the color Kinky. It's a nude very similar to this. And yeah, it's gorgeous. So I'm wearing it right now. It's very glossy and very pigmented, as you can see. So yeah, I highly recommend this if you're looking for a gloss that like actually has color. These were great. I got them for like $11 at Ulta, but I'm pretty sure they're like not having that sale anymore. I didn't know they were having the Smoky palette on sale for $20, and I was so sad. I was like shook that I missed it. I was so mad. I was like totally down to buy the Smoky palette, and I missed it. They sold out. I was really sad. But yeah, great lip gloss, long lasting. You don't have bleeding problems. It's great. This is the Stila Heavens Hue Highlighter in Kitten Karma. As you can see, it is well loved. This stuff is gorgeous. It's the perfect, it's like a cream highlighter. It's beautiful. It's right here. It's just a great, I'm wearing it right now. And it just gives you that, you know, lit from within look. It's so beautiful, and it's perfect if you have dry skin, because for me, I couldn't find a highlighter that worked, because I mean, most of the ones, I mean, they're pretty much all powder. Up until recently, they've released a lot of cream ones, so bless, but it was so hard for me to find a highlighter because it would emphasize my texture so bad that I was like, this doesn't even look good, and I like dewy shit. Why can't I be in on this? When these came out, I was like, yes. So yeah, I love this stuff. It's beautiful. I think I'm gonna pick up the lighter one as well, because sometimes it looks a little too bronzy if I put too much on. So yeah, just highly recommend it. Worth every penny. So the next thing is this concealer, and it is the Rimmel Match Perfection concealer, and this is in 230 long hair probs. This is in 230 fair light. I love this stuff. I love the applicator. I love the coverage of it. It's basically out. I need to go buy a new one. I've been using my Fit Me because I like that too, obviously. But so yeah, it's nice coverage and it's brightening, which is cool. It's such a good concealer. It's so creamy and comfortable. I actually prefer this applicator just because it's easier to apply the amount you want without like scraping your foundation around. So yeah, I actually prefer this, and I love my Fit Me, don't get me wrong, but I'm definitely gonna repurchase this because I really, 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 really like it. It's great coverage. I think I got this recommendation from What Would Lizzie Do? I believe. No, it wasn't What Would Lizzie Do. What's her name? Amy Mercado? Amy Mercado? Something like that. But yeah, great concealer. Next, I got this brow pomade from BH Cosmetics. And it's just, yeah, it's just like a pomade. It's like $8, I think. It might be a little more than that. And this color is in, it doesn't say, BH. Why you do me like this? Oh, it's just blonde. That's the color. But yeah, it's great. I'm wearing it right now. It does a great job of shaping, but also maintaining like a natural looking brow. So yeah, I've been liking that. Another thing I like to do, which isn't very common amongst beauty gurus, but I like to use, and I know I just got this, but like a taupey color like this, but especially this did really well on my brows this morning. Like a taupey color that matches my brows, fills them in really well and gives me a natural looking brow. So if you have the Chocolate Bar palette and like you don't want to go buy a brow product, there's your brow product. It's in your palette. So yeah, great brow pomade. It's cheap, it's affordable, it's BH. You gotta love BH. If you haven't tried BH Cosmetics, you really should. Carly Bible palette, beautiful. Next, I'm gonna do mascaras. I wanna understand why this chaotic mascara got so much hate on YouTube, because I was like wanting to try it because this brush reminds me of, call me crazy, but it reminds me of the Too Faced one. It's obviously not exactly the same, but it looks like it'd give you kind of the same look, right? And I was like, oh, I want to try that. And it got awful reviews on YouTube. Like, all these beauty gurus, like, hated this mascara. And I'm wearing it right now, and I freaking love it. It gives your lashes so much volume. It looks like my Better Than Sex mascara. TBH, I was right. You want a Better Than Sex dupe that doesn't freaking, what's it called? When it, oh, that doesn't flake, and it looks exactly like when you put it on. Because that's the problem a lot of people have with the Better Than Sex. It'll flake, and like, it looks amazing when you put it on, but like, over time, it, you know, doesn't look as good. This looks exactly like the Better Than Sex right when you put it on, but it lasts all day. It's an amazing mascara. I highly recommend it. I don't know why it got so much hate. I love this stuff. I'm gonna repurchase it. It's very well loved, as you can tell. Like, I've only had this like a month or two, and I'm like destroying it. The next one I've been using all month is the CoverGirl Supersizer Fibers, and I love this stuff. It's very lengthening, very volumizing. I find that it does what my L'Oreal Telescopic does, but also adds the volume. And this is by CoverGirl. This is by Maybelline. Sorry, Maybelline Chaotic Mascara, CoverGirl Supersizer. And the brush is kind of different, as you know. I'm sure a lot of you have heard about it. But yeah, it's a great mascara. It volumizes, it lengthens. It's great for your lower lash line. Just solid mascara. Okay, so these are the Stila Magnificent Metal Glitter Glow Shadows. And girl, these are worth every single, you know, penny from your savings, because they're expensive, but they are extremely worth it, especially if you're looking for a good glitter for prom. I mean, that is gorgeous. Tell me that's not gorgeous right now. So I'll insert a couple pictures of me wearing that. Yeah, I freaking love these things. Now, a lot of people said they had issues with primer and there are issues with them flaking and stuff, and a lot of people said they couldn't find a good primer. My creative ass took the Hard Candy long lasting primer. I put that over my base of whatever eyeshadow I used. No creasing, no flaking, no glitter everywhere like this. I don't know if you can see it. It's everywhere. No glitter everywhere. It worked great. So if you're looking for a good eyeshadow primer, Hard Candy Long Lasting. It's supposed to be for your face, but honey, you can use it on your eyes because it worked for me. Oh, my face is really dewy. I'm using the Becca Black Backlight Primer. This is my highlighter, but like all of this is from the primer. This is under the Marc Jacobs Foundation. It's very high coverage, so the fact that it's shining through is like, yes. Those are all my favorites. Yeah, it's a good month. A lot of expensive shit that I can't restrain myself from buying, essentially. I really hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you found it helpful. If you have any requests, I'm gonna do a Naked One and Done wear test. And I'm getting the Urban Decay All Nighter Foundation, so you'll see my haul soon. It's in order. So you'll see that soon, but I want to do a wear test on that as well. So yeah, if you have any requests, like if you want to see a tutorial on this, or if you want to see something on this, I have a video on my eyeshadow palettes, but if you want to specifically see this palette, I don't know what y'all want to see. Go ahead and ask. I'm so sorry. I just got hit with any and every illness this month, so I'm really sorry. I'm going to try to get back onto my regular upload schedule next month. It's just been hectic. I've had job interviews and sickness and teeth extractions and new hire paperwork and trainings. This last month is the busiest I've ever been since I've moved to Tucson. Trust me, it's gonna get better next month. I will have an upload schedule, hopefully. If I don't have an official schedule, I will be uploading 2 or 3 times a week for sure. So yeah, I'm really sorry. I just got really busy this month. Like, it was nuts. Just nuts. That's all I can say. So yeah, I hope you guys are having a good day. If you liked the video, please take the time to like and subscribe. I'd love to have you. And I'll see you next time. Bye. We'll stop recording. This is what happens when you have a fucked up screen. I'm tapping. It's not working. I'm gonna lock the screen. That'll stop it. And what's wrong with that? Boy, oh boy, I love it when I fall.